Guys, I'm back for another video, and this one is not gonna be like a funny or a video I make for fun. This, like the Nancy-rama video, it's not as restricted, but it is a sad story. And this is another Ewok video, and it is the Ewok, another Ipsky Ewok that is named Khungata. That orange-eyed Ewok you see bowing a C-3PO is this guy, and even though it's not official and real, I made up a true story. Now, for these Ewok stories, they're usually going to be like happy, sometimes sad, but mostly love of these Ewoks, like Wicket. But this one has a dark story, and it only has one happy segment. Actually, a few, but mostly dark and very sad. So here we go. Now let's go to Khungata's early life. When the sun was about to rise, in the Ewok village, a mother Ewok gave birth to an Ewok that has eyes that has a different coloring. It had dark orange eyes, and his parents thought that he was a monster, so they decided to do something. His parents thought that he was an Ewok just because of his eye color. Usually, Ewoks have dark brown or black eye coloring, but not this one. So they tossed him into a river while the Ewok was crying and desperate for help. He was tossed in a river. And he stopped by a dam. The river was rushing really hard. But when he was crying again, two Ewoks were looking. They heard crying from the river when he stopped by a dam. When they turned over to look at the Khungata's eyes, the two quickly ran away. And other Ewoks have judged them the way his eye coloring. During much years later, once he was like kindergarten age, he walked around Endor, the forest moon of Endor. Every time he found scraps of food, he would eat it. But once he went back to the village, very hungry and lethargic, the other Ewoks became extremely nervous when he came. All he said was, "Hi, I'm back." And he does remember what happened since he was young. And so, all the Ewoks from the village ran away, and Khungata was extremely devastated. And they already know why he picked on him. And so, he became a loner. But Chief Chirpa didn't realize this because he wasn't paying attention. Even Logray, the wise Ewok, told fake stories about him. I told other Ewoks about him that he's gonna take other Ewok souls. But there was only one Ewok that decided to help, and that is Wicket, the main Ewok. He was the only Ewok out of all the Ewoks in the village that wanted to help. And he already knows that this Ewok is desperate. And so, he walked over to him and said what's wrong. And Khungata told everything about what happened to him. And so Wicket decided to help him. So Wicket and Khungata became very good friends for a very long time. But Tebow, yeah, that Ewok with black stripes and the tooth hood, he was utterly disappointed about what he was seeing. And so every time another Ewok passes by to see Wicket, he would hide Khungata somewhere. Because people have been constantly mistreating him. And so, yes, Wicket was, and he accidentally forgot all about T-Bones, barely hung out with them. But then, many years later, like, when they're about, like, third, like, 8 or 9 years old, like, 8 or 9, like, somewhere the age, you know, it's like that, like, the human years, yeah. So, when they became that age, Khungata found another Ewok that he found that was much kinder than Wicket. Lakotep. Khungata was rushing towards Lakotep, but Wicket stops him right away. But Wicket told about everything. And so, but Khungata just wanted a new best friend. But Wicket and Khungata will still be friends. And so, Wicket said somewhat a farewell, and Khungata goes to Lakotep. And so, that was the end of their early life. This was taking place before the Ewok cartoon was set in. But now, let's move on to his somewhat middle early life. Let's go. Okay. When Wicket, when Wicket moved on to his best friend Tebow was super disappointed in Wicket to hang out with them. Wicket told Tebow that he's not a monster, but instead, just a normal Ewok with a normal personality, just a very friendly Ewok. When Khungata was hanging out with Lakotep, they are still pretty young. About like, somewhere like the 11 or 12 age, somewhere right there. And so, many Ewoks have to train him. So, Demzy, Chilbray, Nanta, Ramba, Warrock, and Lumat have to train these two particular Ewoks. As months go by, they started getting much better at using their weapons. Khungata was much better at using the spears, while Lakotep was much better at doing the bow and arrow. Even though one was better than the other, they are now considered skilled Ewoks. And fortunately for Khungata, the Ewoks are starting to get used to him now and started to stop picking on him. But now, there are more bad things happening. And that was it for his early midlife. But now let's move on to his late midlife. And this is where friendship really started to go downhill a lot. And so, let's get ready for this. This is when they had their first argument. Khungata yelled and scolded at Lakotep and said he wanted to be friends with Wispeth. Lakotop, on the other hand, he scolded and yelled at Khungata that he'll be best friends with Tuckat. But this ended their relationship dramatically. This was during Caravan of Court. But then during the Battle of Endor, this was quite a while when they hated each other. But then when the Ewoks were captured by the Marauders, they still hated each other. And they were right next to their cage to start to have a fight and yelled at each other all day. But when during the Battle for Endor, when they all escaped and ran into the forests, when they started battling along, Khungata said sorry to Lakotop. Lakotop said sorry to Khungata. And so he accepted. And then when the more they battled along with each other, the more their friendship started to go up. And they started being friends once again. And they had to say goodbye to Sindel, but they had still become best friends. But now, let's go back to the dramatic stuff. Now this is his late life during Return of the Jedi, and this is where it gets really, really bad. So, during Return of the Jedi, this is a screenshot from Return of the Jedi. And so, this Ewok, he started bowing down to C-3PO and started respecting him. There's no real story about him going to Bright Tree Village. But he and Lakotop separated each other for some reason during the Battle of Endor. But then Khungata, when he was battling more stormtroopers, he was trying to trick an AT-ST. But then his trick failed, and a very unfortunate thing happened. He was crushed by the AT-ST to his death. And Lakotop didn't even realize this. And also, Khungata was crushed deep into the forest, deep into shrubbery. And Lakotop was too busy, didn't even realize Kangada's cries and death and screaming. But even though his screams were cut short. But when the second Death Star was destroyed, when the Ewoks were all celebrating, Lakotop didn't even look like Khungata anywhere, and was very concerned about him. So he rushed deep into the forest. And when he saw Khungata, he saw his bloody remains and shattered bones. Lakotop was completely heartbroken, and his heart cracked into dust and started to cry a lot and mourned his dead body like Rumba did to Nanta, and had a very, very rough time. During the celebration at the village, he tried to enjoy himself about the second Death Star being destroyed, but no, because of his lost friend, he just simply couldn't enjoy himself and slowly walked back to his hut. After the next day, when Lando, Leia, Han, Luke, C-3PO, and R2-D2 go back for more adventures, Wicket heard crying. After the next day, a few hours later, Wicket heard crying in one of the huts. T-Bone Papu followed along. Lakotop was crying in the hut. Wicket told him why. He told everything about what happened to Khungata, about how he died. Pablo and Tebow were certainly saddened.
But Wicket was even more sad and sat right next to Lakotop and told all about the story about how he took care of Khungata and how he saved them from all the bullying.
Lakotop gave him a gentle hug and thanked Wicket so much about how he took care of him and everything. He took care of him from all the bullying. And so Wicket
thanked him back, and Wicket was pleased. He was pleasured.
And so, but Lakotop had to move on from this. He had someone, and obviously losing your friend can cause depression. But Lakotop had to fight through this. He found Rhomba and Lumat. Because Rhomba, yeah. Covering the old heartbreaks with new tattoos. Yes. And so, Rhomba, he was with Lumat. And he told everything about what happened to Nanta. It was a fortunate death about being shot by the ATST, like we saw in the movie. And Lumat accepted Lakotop in. And that's how Khungata's story is. Yes, like I said, it was really dark and sad for an Ewok story. But that is it. So, like, subscribe, and see you for the next video.